Hey guys, watch the spotlight on now with Brad Benedict from Too Close to Home.
You're tuning into the destination for TV superfan discussion, AfterBuzz TV. And now, let the buzz begin. I'm in love
with the shape of you.
Yeah. Like a magnet, although my heart is falling. Welcome everybody to another episode of I'm your host Annika Michelle, and with me is my lovely dancing partner and guest, Brad Benedict, who I challenged him to dance into Ed Sheeran with me today.
This is a tricky challenge.
I'm kind of addicted to this song, I'm not going to lie to you.
It's good. I like Ed Sheeran.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
Yeah, good guy. Good news when it comes to pop music these
days. Well, welcome everybody. Thank you for joining us. And I'm excited to have Brad back on. I don't know if you guys have watched the previous interview we've done with him last year, mm-hmm. when Too Close to Home just came out. And now season two is out.
Season 1B, but yeah.
1B.
They wasn't sure if season two,
that's
1B,
so
whatever.
Weird.
Yeah, 1B. So shot 8 episodes first, like a pilot season. And then, so that was just kind of trial into the market. And so then we got 8 more. And then I think if we go back again, which is looking good, our numbers are good, then we would probably shoot.
Like a full.
Yeah, like 20 or something like that. But that's
and
what we hope.
When did you shoot this one?
Well, I was there for Halloween, so we started in late October and then into early November. But
it was a fast shoot.
It's always a fast shoot. Yeah, I mean, I think we, again, 8 episodes and 8 days of shooting. So luckily we were primed for it this time, and I had a little bit less material than in the first 8. So it was kind of like, you know, at first you're bummed, you want to be in it, and then when you get on set and you're like, okay, I'm smooth sailing, this is okay.
They're, yeah.
So, it was fun though.
And how was it being back with everybody? Like, and there's a lot of new faces too, so like bringing those people in, and then
definitely
the people that you were with since season 1.
Well, it was definitely like going back to school, which is cool because you very quickly make friends and bond. So in those first 3 weeks that we were there, I just became really close with a lot of the cast members. So, and we got together in LA before, or, you know, during the first season, and did a lot of live tweeting and gatherings and stuff. So
that's,
it was awesome.
Fun.
Yeah, to reconvene back in Atlanta and for round 2, kind of knowing what to expect more. But it was certainly very different with the new cast members that came in, which was awesome. It was cool. Everybody was really, really great, and so the chemistry is still awesome. But, you know, it's funny because you kind of have your thing down.
Right.
You know, we finally figured out, like, what we were doing and came together as a group. And then you go back, and it's like a new wrench in the system.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it's good. It always pushes you to, and helps you grow. And everybody was so nice. But I think it's funny. You're, like, halfway through, and you're finally like, oh, now we all know each other, and now we're in it. And then you're gone again, so.
I know. But then a lot of them live out here, so you still see some of them, don't you?
Yeah, well, I saw everybody last week. I was, for the first episode back January 4th, I think.
Yeah.
I was still in Atlanta visiting my family,
okay.
So I missed the group gathering then.
I was gonna
and
ask,
then
yeah.
This past Wednesday, we all meet up at Danielle's house, who plays Annie.
Yeah.
And we get together and tweet. We did a mannequin challenge that'll come
out.
That's
awesome.
I think we're about 2 to 3... maybe 4 months late on it, but it's fun. You know, we'll get quicker with the trends going forward. But I got to see most of the cast there, and that's it's a lot of fun. Lots of hugs, lots of butt slapping, and what? No, that's only with Robert Craighead, the sheriff.
The sheriff.
We have a special relationship.
You did say you have a very special relationship with him. Is he live out here, or is he in Atlanta?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Robert and I definitely have a special thing. We when we met in Atlanta the first time shooting, I was telling him about a dream project of mine, a script that I was trying to develop, set in the country music world. So we talked about last time, I'm a big country music fan, play guitar, sing, try to sing. And so I told him my idea, and he was like, well, man, that's funny you say that, because I got a country, music film. And he had worked with a guy named Paul Overstreet.
Yeah,
you guys might know Cord Overstreet.
Cord Overstreet, yes.
He's in Glee, and
the dad, right?
And Paul is a multi Grammy winner, and he's written several number ones over the years for different artists, and just a really incredible guy. And they worked together on a play that was featuring all of Paul's music. Robert was the lead, and now I think they're collaborating on a film that Robert wrote.
Yeah.
And so that immediately kind of was something we bonded over. I played him some of my songs, and he was impressed. And then since we got back, we've kind of come together. I'm trying to weasel my way in this film.
Yeah, and, as you should.
No, but it's looking like it might happen, and it would kind of be my dream role, which was to play a singer-songwriter, country singer-songwriter, and the script's really awesome. And so if it works out, you know, hoping to shoot this summer. And it's gonna be kind of my introduction to the world with music and just the cool thing. So Robert and I've become, you know, he's like major mentor to me. He's the guy that's out, you know, and meeting people and friends everywhere and has so many connections. He's been in the business so long. And so he really showed me after we first shot just what it, you know, get out there, say yes, and you can make friends so easily all over the place. Easy. It's been fun.
That's awesome that he kind of like took like you and like a son or somebody that he cares about and like watched over you and he's trying to help you with the script. And if you do it, would you sing your own like songs?
Yeah, I would definitely be doing the singing. You know, this is all, those are answers that I don't necessarily have.
Right.
But no, the idea is he would, you know, he's going to sing and I'm going to sing. And we even went to Nashville and cut some tracks, like scratch tracks to use and kind of to put out there. Give people a little idea of what we're doing. But yes, the goal would be that I would actually get to use some of my original songs.
That would be amazing.
In the film, because it would be a really cool way to just put that out there.
Bring that out, yeah.
You know, be scary for sure. It's my kind of big insecurity, but it's also what I want them.
But you have to do that
dreams.
For it to get there. You have to.
So I got to put in some work this year, get some, you know, make sure I'm playing a lot and maybe try to get a gig or something.
Oh yeah, that'd be fun. Like the little Hollywood clubs around here, they do a lot of like acoustic gigs or acoustic nights.
I don't know if anybody knows the little coffee shop on Hollywood Boulevard called Tiago.
Tiago's.
It's just like right on Hollywood and La Brea.
Okay.
And I live right there. So it's kind of like a spot I go down and read scripts and stuff. And they have this outside wooden stage.
Oh.
And I looked and I was like out there one day and I was like, is there power? And there's a power outlet. And I was like, man, nobody uses this. So my, you know, someday I have this idea in my head that I'm going to go down there and be like, we should do some live, you know, like acoustic music. But first, maybe I'll go out at like 4 a.m. by myself, plug in my like my amp and
do
just
it yourself
give it,
and
yeah,
try
give it,
it. Yeah.
Give it a shot and be like, all right, I got this.
Like, it's like a coffee shop or a bar?
No, coffee shop.
Coffee shop,
I don't know if they may sell beer or something, but no, it's like coffee, cafe.
That's cool.
It's cool.
You
it's
should
cool
do
spot.
It. I feel like that would be the place. And you kind of have like a rapport with them if you go all the time, I feel like.
I'm not a regular yet, but
just go a few more times.
Someday, we'll make it happen. And not ready yet, but.
Okay. I want this to happen for you.
Yeah.
So being back and everything, you said it was cool to be with the cast, but what was your favorite thing about shooting the season?
Oof.
It could be a favorite episode that you shot.
Mm-hmm.
I know we haven't seen too many of them. We've only seen two.
Yeah. And I'm, you know, my storyline is pretty condensed. But I like it because what's fun is that I'm always kind of off doing
your own
my
kind
own
of thing.
Thing.
Yeah.
So I definitely would say this season, I was talking to Ty. We were out to dinner right before we started shooting, I think, you know, the night or two nights before. And he had mentioned a girl on one of his other shows, and she was kind of the villain or, you know, bad girl. And not such a nice character. And he was just talking about how, you know, after kind of getting into it, she's like, yeah, like, I'm going to lean into this. I'm going to really have fun with it. If I'm going to be bad, I'm going to be real bad.
Right.
And so I think it was like, yeah, you know what, Lynn, like, okay, I hope everybody hates me. So the point being is what I had fun doing this time around is I think really being comfortable just going, you know, leaning even more into the I don't even know the word. I don't even think he's a bad boy. Bad boys are, you know, just they hurt themselves, but this guy JB so far is hurting other people.
Yeah,
so
he has like no remorse, I feel like.
Yeah. He does. He
you
does.
You think so?
I mean,
he has remorse, but I feel like he doesn't have a heart sometimes when he, like...
My goal would definitely be to eventually find, you know, pieces of the character that, you know, I have to empathize with his thoughts, at least in somewhere. I can't play the role.
Right.
So I get it a little bit when, in my own brain, what he's thinking, and I'm hoping that eventually, whether he turns good or keeps breaking bad, whatever... that at least the audience could see that there are, you know, they could empathize with him a bit, and that's gonna, you know, that'll take some work if he keeps on these actions. But yeah, it was fun just to go for it and be crazy. And it was kind of a bummer in a little bit, because last time we'd all show up in the morning. I feel like everybody in the cast would be there every morning.
Yeah.
Hair and makeup's one of the best times of the day, because you're in there with coffee going and you got energy and everybody's buzzing and excited for a good day. And because I kind of had a more of a storyline outside the all these other guys, I felt like I was alone a lot of times.
Aww.
At show, there was like one or two other people in there, and so that was definitely a really different part of filming this time around, where I felt a little bit, just didn't see everybody as much,
right?
And you know, go in and get it done, and I missed it, because that's the biggest,
bonding part.
The fun is really laughing with everybody, but we still got time to do that. But it was different. It was just a little bit different, you know?
Yeah. So then, because you didn't get to see everyone that you wanted, is there someone in the cast that you wish you had more scenes with?
I mean, that's always a common question. Like, who do you want to work with?
Yeah.
Or
who do you wish you had more scenes with? I feel like you kind of have scenes.
I've kind of been pretty, I've gotten in there with a lot of people, and then I've just met Dax's character.
Right.
This past week. And I was very excited to work with Nick, because Nick was one of the first, I don't know if I said talked about this last time, but Nick Ballard, who plays Dax, was one of the first people in LA that I met. I think he was a little bit, had been in the business a little bit longer. I was fresh from Atlanta. And one of my first jobs I booked was like a modeling gig at a trade show, like Magic.
Yeah.
Out in Las Vegas. So we were working for William Rast Jeans, Justin Timberlake, I think it was his jean company.
Yeah.
And we stayed in a room together. And so I was very much like, oh, you got a soap opera audition tomorrow. And like, whoa, that's so cool. And you work.
And we
became buds, and you'd see each other around town, but hadn't hung out much. And then the first time, we saw each other at the call back in Atlanta, and it was so great because we had so much to catch up on.
Yeah.
That it really kept my head, calm. And then we both got to book the show. And so this year, getting to work with him has been a cool new thing. But yeah, all the characters, I don't know. It'd be cool to work with Heather someday.
Yeah.
The first lady, Heather Locklear, obviously, been a fan of hers for a long time growing up. I watched more of 90210 growing up.
Yeah.
And I think Melrose was like an hour later, and it was even a little edgier. But my mom... Yeah. My mom said, "Yeah, that's just smut." That was her word, and I hated
smut.
It. Yeah, smut. Yeah, it's like, okay, mom. So my mom's pretty conservative. I hope she watches this. She'll get a kick out of that.
Would be cool if you did like a scene with her.
Well, I want secretly what
you
I'm
hoping.
You want
to hook up with her?
I was thinking about it the other day, and I was like, I hope that JB and like that would be such. Wouldn't that be a cool?
That would be like a
so
cool.
So I think JB and First Lady need to like start dating or something. Yeah.
Or just revenge on the president.
Or revenge, Somehow they need to link up, and there's always smooching involved when you're trying to get revenge.
100%.
Right.
100%. How else would you get the revenge?
I don't know. Yeah.
Exactly.
Solidarity.
Exactly. No, that would be kind of cool. I was actually
amazing. Imagine that. Little kid, like, who knew?
You'd be, like, making out with her.
Well, I mean, even just getting to work with her, but that would be cool, too.
Okay. Yes. I'm just throwing it, like, one step further for you. Just in case, like, Tyler's watching this, so, like, I could, pitch the idea out for you.
Yes.
Yeah. You never know. Mm-hmm. I kind of, in a weird way, want you to, like, get, because you know how Brody hooked up with the two sisters,
Bonnie and Annie. Yeah.
I want you to hook up with both of them, but not the same time, obviously. I mean, maybe not obviously, but like.
I mean, if it's gonna happen on a show, this is the one that it can.
I just feel like, but I don't.
What? So you want what to happen now?
Okay, I want two things to happen, but for these two things to happen, I feel like it won't. I want your relationship with Brody to get better, but if you hook up with them, that's not gonna. That's gonna get further apart.
Well, Bonnie's my girl. And so he's already moving in on my territory.
Right.
And then Annie, that's
a dangerous
territory. That's the third sister I've yet to conquer. Because in episode one, Shelby, Shelby felt JB's wrath, That sounds weird.
Yeah.
That's not what I meant to say. Shelby and JB link up. So, heck yeah.
I mean, you never know. But I do like the president idea for sure. Mm-hmm. I feel like Tyler should definitely...
President's wife.
Wife, not the president. Not
yet.
Not that step, but quite yet. Yeah. But that would be cool. That would be a funny... We'll see. Not funny, but that would be an intense...
Yeah, I'm learning that that's one of the fun things about getting to be on a TV show, especially like this one, is that you know, you have no idea where the character is going, and you have to try and figure out where they've been.
Right.
From where we ended it, it's totally in the writer's hands and in Tyler's hands. So it's fun. You get that script and you just get fired up and to see all the juice and see what happens next.
Yeah.
As long as you're alive.
This is true. And is it nerve-wracking to shoot scenes like that? Like hooking up scenes? Because I feel like it's not like real life, you know, they don't really have cameras and someone directing you to do this or that. But is it weird with like people watching, or is it just like whatever?
No, the people watching certainly is not, that's not weird, because it's nothing, because there's zero like intimacy or zero like, you know, it's zero sexuality at all. Yeah. It's completely just
like the going actions, through the motions. Going through the...
But no, I mean, it's a little, you get some butterflies for sure. And definitely the first time I did anything like that in little short films back in the day and stuff. Oh yeah, I mean, like a 22-year-old kid and like this beautiful girl and. It was certainly scary, but now when you realize how just silly it really is, it's fun. It's, you need to have a little chat with your scene partner beforehand and be like, this is, you know, like what's safe, what's not, and make sure you guys are on
the same page.
But no, it's fun. It's just silly.
That's good.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's good.
Just make believe.
Yeah, this is true.
I definitely don't feel like I could have. I think it would have been hard as a young, you know, in my like early 20s, a young actor, like seeing my girlfriend kissing a guy on the show. And now it's like, once you do it, you're like, whatever.
It's not like a big deal.
Have fun.
So you wouldn't even care if your girlfriend did that?
I don't think so. I mean, I guess
you'd have to see.
If I ever was in that position. Yeah, but I think I certainly could look back. I've seen it happen in my, you know, in acting classes when you're girls right in front of you smooching on another guy.
That's true.
Whatever.
It's true. Well, that's good. It's true though, because it is just like whatever. Like, I think it looks passionate to people, but it's like, okay,
yeah,
we're done. Mm-hmm. And it's even better if you have to do it to someone that you can't stand. I don't know if you've ever had to experience but okay, good. Well, hopefully you won't have to.
I like all my
that's good. That's really good.
Yeah.
That makes a big difference. But I really, back to Brody and you, I do want you guys to get better. I want you guys to get like, and you guys are like, I need you to come back together.
Yeah, I mean, I think the only way you can have that much animosity towards each other and it can be that loaded is if there's, you know, if you care about somebody.
Right.
You think about, like, a lot of the worst fights you have, or the, you know, sometimes the meanest you are to the people that you really love and care about. So, you know, I believe that Brody and JB desperately, like the little boys inside of them, really want to, would love to be able to lean on each other. They lost their mom, and, you know, and Dr. Allen is falling apart, and I don't even know, you know, who my dad is yet. And, so I think that, the reason they're so much at each other's throat is because they desperately want to be able to, like, have each other and love each other and be brothers. So we'll see what happens.
I hope it gets rekindled. Can you give us any, like, upcoming teasers? Because like I said, we've only seen two.
Mm-hmm.
The third one is airing tomorrow.
Yeah.
So we just want to, you know, get a little bit of something, like give us something.
Yeah, well, definitely this week I'm really excited about one of my scenes.
Okay.
I can tell you that it might be the scene that I'm, you know, most excited for the audience to see. And I'm really curious what their reaction will be. It's so tricky not to give anything away.
Yeah.
But my character, what I enjoy about this season is every episode he ramps up and gets more and more and more and more intense.
Yeah.
And so I definitely think that there's going to be some, you know, gasping open mouths watching and people might love me more or hate me more.
Oh.
I'm not sure, but you start to get a little bit more into JB's past and his psyche.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the scene at all? Like, why is this scene your favorite?
It was a challenge as an actor to shoot.
Okay.
I'll tell you that much. Just like the kind of what my character is going through was something foreign to me in real life, and something I had never been through. And so that's, you know, that in and of itself is tricky to really kind of figure out what the truth would be in that setting. So
yeah,
just kind of rolling with it. That's about all you get, but definitely tune in this week and tell me afterwards. You guys tweet me, or
are you gonna be live tweeting this week with the
I'm sure we will, yeah.
West and East Coast.
We've made it a habit to definitely do the East Coast and West Coast. I've been typically then actually get to watch the episode. You live tweet and then he's like, what actually happened? And then go back at the West Coast and I watch it. But yeah, heck yeah, I'll be there. If anybody's got anything to say or ask or whatever, I'll certainly be keeping up with the tweeting. But people out there, tell me what you think of this this JB scene coming up.
Okay, I might even tweet you. You never know.
Well, you better.
I might. This is it.
Don't text me. You got to tweet.
Okay, I'll tweet so the whole world sees. Yeah, 100%. I'm doing it.
Just all of our
West Coast time. I'm doing it. I'm gonna live tweet y'all. So okay. I hope you guys join in too and live tweet with me. Mm-hmm. Not with live tweet, but tweet at you.
Yeah.
So weird, all this terminology.
It's all live. I mean, who knows? It's such a different world than can't imagine what it was like 10 years ago. But got to be on the social media nowadays.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It's fun though.
It is fun. You get to connect with people that I feel like you otherwise would not have the chance to.
Yeah, I've done a lot of that lately. Really just trying to
be
to,
on top of it.
Yeah, just to interact, and it's fun. A lot of people have reached out, especially like I started this Facebook fan page, just give it give it a go, and that's been where I've been able to really kind of communicate with people.
That's awesome.
Around the states, and it's been a lot of fun. So you guys hit me up on there.
Yeah,
I've been able to stay on it, but I think I've been shirking on some of my other life responsibilities.
It's okay.
But
you're promoting a show. That's work. Yeah.
Promoting a show, and it's just fun to get to
interact with people.
Yeah, because you make a show wanting to entertain people, and like that's a big part of getting to make it is getting to then see people see them with their response, and whether it's good or bad. So I like to do that.
Do you have any crazy fan stories?
Mm-hmm.
Any yet? Has anyone been like? It could be crazy good or crazy bad, but I really mean like crazy.
No.
You don't have nothing. To give names or, if
no,
they're
I'm,
watching.
No, I'm trying to think. Nothing really yet, but I was surprised. There's a couple times when I was recognized. And it was just, it's just a new thing, and it's fun, and people, appreciate you. And
they want to take selfies and stuff,
that's awesome. We went to Nashville. I went to Nashville with Craighead.
Oh, nice.
And,
by the way, have you seen that show? I was going to ask
Nashville?
You that.
Yeah, that's like one of my dream shows to be on.
Okay.
And, yeah, I
just
love,
making
love
sure.
Nashville. Love Nashville.
Yeah.
The duets. Hold on. Now we got to talk about Nashville. Like the duets
so
between
good.
Gunner and Scarlett are. That's my favorite thing on Nashville.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
They all have amazing voices.
Yeah, their harmonies, like, that's what the show really does for me. The harmonies, it just makes you, makes me go crazy. That's my favorite thing. Two, a guy and a girl, or anybody really, but singing acoustic harmonies, yeah.
Yeah.
It's bueno.
It's magic.
I don't even know where I was
going
with that.
You went to Nashville.
Oh, just Nashville, and we were at a thing for Paul Overstreet with Craighead, and he was being honored at the Country Music Hall of Fame.
Okay.
And it was really neat, and so we went down to kind of where this stage was sort of afterwards, and he had written a song with a guy named Taylor Dunn before.
Okay.
And I believe, I don't know if it went number one. I can't remember the name of the song, but love it.
Yeah,
amazing.
Yeah.
And we went down there, and Taylor's family happened to be big fans of the show.
Oh my gosh, how funny.
So I'm there Paul Overstreet, just appreciating him and his talent and wanting to take pictures with them. And they came down and, wanted to take pictures with me and Robert, and that was just a lot of fun. And I think their grandmother, Meemaw, hit me up on
Meemaw, love it.
She hit me up on Facebook today, actually, and was like, hey, I'm 84. I'm the 84-year-old watching Too Close to Home, and I can keep up. And had me send pictures that we had taken together. She's very short and cute.
Aww.
And so snuggly, and so that was fun.
That's adorable.
Yeah.
I love that you have an 84-year-old Meemaw fan.
Yeah, I would love if Meemaw watched this right now.
I mean, you never know. Send her the link.
Well,
you just gave her a little shout-out.
Yeah, I will.
I think it would make her day.
I'll definitely send her the link.
That's awesome. That's
she
the
made,
cutest.
She made my day, for sure. It was really sweet.
And I'm sure you made hers.
I don't know. I guess. I hope so.
I think you did. Yeah. If she went on Facebook to acknowledge and reach out to you, yeah. I feel like you made some kind of an impact.
Yeah, it's fun.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. That's really good. Would you say, like, if you could pick any other character in Too Close to Home, that if Tyler was like, you could be anybody else, you can play the character for the rest of the season, anybody else, who would you pick? I guess I will. Let's make this a bit more fun, guy or girl.
Whew. All right. There's so many fun characters to play. I haven't played enough guy characters to start wanting to play girl characters yet, so let me get that first. I think Brock's character, getting to be Brody, who's kind of the hero of the show, would be a fun thing to experience. I get to experience the polar opposite right now. And it would be fun to experience it as Brock, where, you know, you have 2.5 million, you know, women going just crazy, loving you no matter what.
I'm sure you get some of that too. It's not all going to him.
Yeah, no, it's pretty but much all.
But here's the thing:
to him.
It's because but your character,
you know,
his character is a bit more lovable. Like, oh, he's taking care of the dad. Oh my God, the dad's sick. Look at him. Oh, like, you know.
Well, he's also an Adonis, so you
he's
know.
Also Tarzan. Let's get real. Yeah, exactly. So,
but no, certainly the character's written in a, you know, in a sweeter way. It'd be fun. I would love to, if we did an episode, it's like a spin-off weird, like, you know, extra scenes, and like had everybody playing different characters. That would be pretty cool.
And would you have him play you then?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, that would be the best.
Heck yeah.
Just to see him to do that, like that mean, douchey character.
I mean, I feel like Brock this season and the little bit we've seen of him is already, he's showing a little bit more of his, not dark side, but, you know, he's got a little edge
tougher
under
side,
there too.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, you're not going to mess with me. And he was very sweet during the first season, and this was it was cool to start to see that, that if you mess with Brody, you know, you'll pay the price.
I mean, who's really messing with him? The guy is like 7 foot tall. No one's going to try, I feel like, but I could be wrong.
I'll try.
Okay.
Again, I already got cracked in the ribs.
Yeah. One more. That's not going to stop you.
No, it's fun.
That's awesome.
I'm going to learn jujitsu.
Oh, so, like, that's insane.
I don't think I'd ever take Brock in a boxing match.
Yeah.
But I feel like if I knew like how to grapple, then there's a chance that I could just get lucky and wrap him up, you know, in a headlock or something.
Right. I feel like he can just pick up like anybody with a finger, like, well, you know, like just,
well,
I don't know.
Maybe. I mean,
I think you can do it though. If anyone.
Yeah. You gotta be fast.
You have to be fast.
It's like Bruce Lee. He may have been 140 pounds, but he could whip some big boys' butts.
This is true.
He's got skill and moxie.
This is very true. Have you taken any classes yet?
Not too many. I did recently start taking very introductory Krav Maga, and just some bag classes and, you know, heavy bag and it's more of like an aerobic, you know, you're doing push-ups, whatever, and then you get on the bag and do some combos and some kicks, and it's awesome.
That's so cool.
I've always wanted, I think a lot of people like kind of think a bucket list to learn a martial art, but I'm hoping that this is the year of eating more fish, eating more vegetables, and learn a martial art.
Okay.
That would be
cool.
I like
that eating more fish is above the other two.
Well, it's just, they're all even. The year of the vegetable, really. Vegetables save your life. Eat more vegetables. I don't eat enough vegetables, but not really into the Krav yet, but I've definitely, you know, done some dabbling, and I tried some yoga recently, and it's all harder than you think.
Yeah. It's tough.
It's fun.
It is fun. It's definitely fun.
If any single dudes out there are looking to meet chicks,
I'm telling you,
go to yoga.
There's like 30 if I'm to one guy.
Dude, there's no guys. It does. It blows my mind. I get that yoga's not like, it's like not a super testosterone filled thing, but you go to these classes and there's no guys and like these beautiful girls wearing tight pants with their butts in the air, and it's like, I don't understand why there aren't more guys there.
Or like, even I feel like guys would not go to this either, but I don't know if you've ever done like a cardio bar class.
I did one bar class at this studio. They do bar as well.
I swear it's the same thing. It's like 30 girls in tight like yoga pants, like you said, and it's like no guys anywhere to be seen.
Dude, I was doing like the plies or whatever.
Yes, on the bar. It's intense. Your butt will feel it.
Oh my Lord. I was definitely feeling the booty.
You will feel it for sure.
I think they were kind of laughing. You know, I felt like I was being laughed at the whole time.
Did you go with a friend or did you just on your own?
Yeah. I went with a girl.
Okay.
And it was fun. And, you know, so I had my partner there. But But it was definitely challenging, just the burn.
Insane, right?
But I think that's probably why more guys don't go to yoga and bar and type of things, I think, because you got to be willing to look silly. So you might not. It's hard. Ego wise, it's tough. But
like you said, put the ego aside, you will meet a lot of beautiful girls.
Yeah, that's the dudes who always do the guys who aren't afraid to like make a joke or say hi. You know, like those are the guys who win.
There's no opposite thing for girls though. Like a girl can't go to like, I mean, I guess you could go to like a weight gym, but it's not like the same, you know, you guys, can't just go to like a class. And
sometimes those guys seem a little bit more interested in themselves, you know.
Like, sometimes.
Yeah,
then
the
it's like. In LA, it's like all the time.
Yeah, I mean, I'm guilty. I've definitely sat there, you know, checking out the guns in the mirror.
Yeah.
I don't know. What could girls do?
There is
nothing,
I feel like.
Surf lessons? Go out there surf and surf with the guys?
Surf is fun. That's so much fun.
Yeah, I'm not very good. I've not yet picked it up, but I want to.
I caught my first wave in Hawaii in Waikiki Beach.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's a good
place to do it, right?
Yeah. Every time I've tried, the surf has been pretty rough. I don't think the conditions have been well. And then when I shot this, the Tennis Channel show that I hosted, we did one where surfing was cross training for tennis potentially. And so we were out in Malibu, and I was in some pretty big waves, crashing hard.
Oh my god!
So it wasn't pretty, but we brought a photographer who was out there with fins on underwater. So that was cool.
Gosh.
It felt like I was in a cool surf show, and some of the footage was great. But yeah, I just haven't really nailed it yet.
It's hard. It takes a lot of upper body strength, and I don't think people. I didn't know that when I got into it. When I did it, I was like, oh my god, because you can't, it's not like swimming, it's like your hands are like this to row you out.
Yeah, it's hard.
It's hard, your arms are dead by the time you get out to take the surf back in, and then like, if you don't dip under, you're getting thrown back, and it was just...
Yeah, I went to Bali last...
Oh, sweet.
Over Thailand, and then to Bali after New Year's last year, so in 2016, early 2016, I was there.
Yeah.
And rented a surfboard in Bali, and it looked like it was going to be, you know, doable. And got out there, and like you said, I was spent by the time I got out there, and then it was actually a reef bottom.
Oh my gosh.
And I've heard the warnings, like, if you're not experienced, do not surf on a reef. So I basically rented a board, took a half an hour to finally get out there, was exhausted, saw the reef, and like, you know, went around and went back, and I was like, I'm gonna just catch some rays today.
Yeah.
So,
it's hard. Those things
didn't want to risk it.
Are not fun if you fall into them.
No, dude.
It's not good.
Destroy the face, the whole bod.
Yeah. Scars. No, we can't do that.
Cool reef when you, like, in the eye.
No. Yeah, but that's, surfing is a good way. That's true.
Mm-hmm.
These are some other questions, not to do with too close to home, but I feel like the world wants to know these things about you.
Okay.
So here we go. Are you ready?
Maybe.
You're for sure going to have fun with this. Okay, what are five fun things that we don't know about you?
Okay. That's so hard.
Is it?
Yeah.
Can you pick like two things we don't know about you? I feel like people don't know much, right?
Okay. Well, I'll just tell a little bit about myself.
Okay.
I grew up in Norcross, Georgia, suburbs of Atlanta.
Yeah.
I was the youngest of four, so I had an older brother, Charles, then sister Jennifer, sister Lindsay, then me, so I'm the baby. So
I definitely... So you got, like, the special attention.
I think that's part of the disease of, like, liking to be the center of attention, which led me to be an actor, but now I've figured out, I think, how to make it healthy. I used to want to be a veterinarian, so I love animals. So growing up, my mom, starting in kindergarten, would check me out of school, and I'd go to the vet's office and follow him, and I'd watch surgeries. So I remember being like literally in the dog, like getting neutered, getting knee surgery.
And that didn't freak you out or like gross you out in any way, shape, or form?
No, I loved it. I think I'd be more grossed out now, so I got to do that. And I studied finance in college and was like on my path. I had a job waiting in Wall Street. So I graduated early, came out to LA to kind of dabble for 6 months and have some fun. And then ended up the day before I was supposed to go to train in Wall Street. I said, I couldn't leave LA yet. Couldn't leave the dream.
Yeah.
Even though I had nothing going on and I was still like depressed and lonely and had no friends out here and like whatever.
Everyone goes through that, I feel like, though. It's hard.
Your first time, you know, coming to, especially for me, I was on the tennis team and I played college tennis.
We're playing doubles with.
Yes, we're going to play some doubles with John Isner.
I call him Isner.
Yeah, a lot of people do. It's okay.
Isner.
Get it right.
Whatever his name is, he's going down.
John Isner, 19th in the world right now, I think. Playing at the Australian Open. Support him. Go Dogs, Georgia Bulldogs. But yeah, it's hard anytime you come to LA. But I don't know what else. I love the ocean. I really hope that I get to work in conservation, coral reef, shark conservation someday. I just went to Costa Rica.
Right. How was that? Fun?
Yeah, it was really fun. I had a buddy. I was not planning this trip, and a buddy in Atlanta, and he's like, you know, let's be crazy. Let's book something. So like 2 days before, I had my friends from LA mail my passport to me in Atlanta.
Oh my gosh.
And we went to a town called Hako, this little surf town, kind of beach town rather, in Costa Rica.
Yeah.
And went fishing. I caught an 11-pound or 11-foot blue marlin.
What?
Which was crazy. I still have blisters like healing from the fight. I would never have expected it. It was so nuts, and let it go. Swimming and kicking.
As you
that's
should,
important.
Yeah.
I know some people who see the picture like would be very disappointed.
Upset, yeah.
But I have no interest in keeping. So that was a lot of fun, and now I'm back at it.
Okay. I like it. That's I think a bit more than five, but I love it. I think that's
I always
fun
talk
fact.
Too much.
No, it's great.
That's number five.
That's
I always talk too much.
There it is. Yeah. No, it's always good. It's better to talk too much than not enough. And I don't think you talk too much. Uh-huh. So I think it's great.
Thank you.
What is your life motto? Do you have like a life motto you go by?
No, I probably do. I love quotes and that stuff because they really can be super poignant and hit you and really, it's like, yeah, that's so spot on. I have like my own little like prayer that I always go to.
Okay.
I don't even know if it's a prayer. It's just my chant kind of. And
yeah.
All it is, please give me the strength to be courageous in times of adversity. And
yeah.
I use that. I like to say that to myself, it's just kind of, you know, because it covers everything. It's like, I don't know, you know, I think life is tough, and it's just like, I'm not asking to not go through the tough times, but I just want
to have the courage to go through it. Yeah.
When it's happening and it's tough, I just want to make sure I can be a man and stand up. I think I quoted Winston Churchill in an interview I did recently, and it was something like, be a man in success and a gentleman in defeat. That's not the exact quote. But
that's something along those lines. Yeah.
Essentially, that would be a motto that I'm trying to bring to Brad Benedict's life is, you know, just stand up, be a man when your good things are happening, and when it's not, you know, when you're losing or tough times, still be a gentleman. And not always the easiest thing to do.
It's not easy. But if it was easy, everybody would do it, right?
Yeah. You know, it never be shut off to growth. I think so often people just kind of quit wanting to learn new, you know, the old dog learn new tricks type thing. And I think it's just really kind of an epidemic where people stop evolving. And that's one cool thing about living in LA and picking a job like acting where there's no real security is, you know, you're always having to kind of figure yourself out, reinvent yourself, learn from other people, and you get exposed to so many different people. So that's probably the biggest gift that's come from this so far.
That's good.
See, I answered more than the question she asked.
I love
there.
It, though.
That's the talking.
No, I love it. I love it. And finish this sentence. Can't live without. And don't say like
exercise,
air and stuff.
Exercise.
Okay, that's a good answer.
Yeah, I'm reading this book about habits, and it makes a lot more sense now why. And you hear don't make exercise and nutrition, don't make it like a binge type thing, you know, getting ready for the summer. You got to make it part of your lifestyle. And it's been a part of my lifestyle for a long time. And but anyways, this book of habits talks about cues and rewards and kind of teaches you how addictions happen and habits grow.
Yeah.
And so I learned, you know, like I think fitness truly isn't an addiction. You your body when gets, you know, likes those endorphins and what, you know, the sense of accomplishment and all that. So then when you don't get it, it's not just, a lot of people I think who work out a lot could agree with this after 4 or 5 days a week, whatever, when you get out of the gym, you start to feel like sad, depressed,
and,
you know, like
and just like groggy and not as upbeat.
And it's such an easy fix a lot of times because you get those chemicals moving and you have a sense of accomplishment. It's like mind, spirit, mind, and body. So I guess exercise, but family is also...
That's our two good answers.
I think family is probably actually the number one thing.
Yeah.
I'm really grateful for my family.
And you're super close with them.
Really close. Yeah, we've been through some very tricky times.
Yeah.
And that is...
Are any of them in the industry too, or...?
No, they should be. My sister, Lindsay, who acted before me in high school, she did Grease the year before I did my first play, and she was so good.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I dropped the diamond in my macaroni. that's the line I remember.
That's awesome.
I think she played Marty.
Yeah.
But she's great. She sings. She's beautiful. Yeah. She was just out here last week. And,
sweet.
I wish she would do it. She lives in Atlanta still. She's a nurse now.
Okay.
And it was just one of those stories where you grow up in Atlanta, you don't really think it's possible. And also, it's a big risk, you know?
I
took the leap. And then people think, oh, it's too late. I can't now. That's so ridiculous. I hate that. Don't do that. There's professional athletes. Like, that's like one area where maybe it can physically get too late. But so being in Atlanta and a nurse, I think she works typically 3 days a week. And I'm like, dude, get in an acting class, find an agent, and just start playing. And if not, at least it's still a fun way to meet
do
new people and
yeah.
challenge yourself. But I hope she does. And my brother is also very handsome and gregarious and awesome. And so I'm hoping to push them all in there. And then my sister, Jennifer, who's a mom of four boys.
Oh, wow. Four boys. Oh, my gosh.
And also beautiful. I don't know that she has any interest in it.
Right.
But I got my dad. She would be great too. She's like the talent. She's good at everything. We go bowling and she never bowls. She beats us video
That's
games.
Awesome.
Like everything. But my dad, this is actually fun.
Yeah.
I brought him in and had him do extra work on Too
my
Close
gosh.
To Home.
My gosh. Wait, when can we see him or where is he?
I think it would be probably in, episode 4 maybe. I don't know if you'll see him or not, but he had a cowboy hat and boots and he was in the honky tonk.
Okay, is he talking to you at all in the scene?
No, that
are
we,
you,
we
are you talking
that,
to him?
We should have made that happen. He was playing pool at one of the pool tables, and he was so mad because it's so funny. He's like, they didn't have a cue ball. Like I'm sitting there and I'm shooting it, and I was like, Dad, it's okay. Like don't worry about it. And he really wanted to commit to that role.
Yeah.
He wanted a cue ball when he was playing pool, but
he's not asking for too much.
It was a blast to have him there and just to get to see it a little bit. He's been around for a couple of things I've done. He came out when I shot my web series with my buddy and was just kind of like my right hand man and like saved my butt there. And he was my tennis coach growing up, so we've always had a thing. And mom really wants to get in there next time, so we'll get her on. But then what was cool, Ozzy, who's one of the producers of the show, got us set up and gave us a driver to go around all around Fort McPherson.
Oh, wow.
Which is where Tyler's studios are that he's building. Because my grandfather, who was a 2-star general in the Army, professor at West Point, like super amazing man, he used to be stationed there, and so I got to go into the house where my grandfather lived 40 years ago on Fort McPherson and walk through, and my uncle and my grandmother and uncle used to live there, my
That's
uncle
so
Lance
crazy.
And so that was a
how
cool
was
thing.
That like
it was
surreal
super, it was super neat. Yeah, you know, I think it's easy to take for granted people like wise men. You can't become wise without experience, and so my grandfather passed away a few years ago, and then afterwards you're like, man, I just wish I could have asked him more questions. All these things come out afterwards, like, wow, he was like a war hero, and just there's so many special things. So it was cool to get a glimpse inside of his past and just connect with him a little bit, and also fun for me to get to do that with my dad, because you know it's his father, and so to kind of feel like I got to bring him closer a little bit was cool.
That's awesome. I'm glad you got to. That's so cool that they hooked you up with that. That's so sweet of them.
They're so nice. Yeah, Ozzy
that's
was like,
so sweet
give
of them.
10 minutes, you know, we'll get a car for you. And so
oh my gosh,
VIP
how cool.
Treatment.
Well, I'm going to be looking out for your dad at the honky-tonk playing pool with no cue ball.
Oh, and he got to meet Heather.
Oh, really?
I'm
sure he would love that.
Yeah, that was a crack up. She was so
that's
sweet.
So
and like,
cool.
You guys are so cute, and aww. You know, look at those eyes. And my dad, I would look over, and he's just giddy. He's a flirt, in a totally good great way.
Right.
But so I think he enjoyed it.
That's awesome.
Trying to tease a little bit.
Yeah, that's great. Well, I'm gonna ask you a fan question, and then we have to go because I didn't realize what time it was. My gosh.
It
okay.
It goes quick.
It does go fast. Okay, this is from Kathy.
Okay.
And she wants to know, will JB ever get a bit of a backstory about him and Brody? That's what she wants to know.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I can't answer that for sure.
Right.
Hey, Kathy, by the way. I have a feeling I know Kathy. I have a feeling we've
you've tweeted before?
Tweeted
questions?
There's a Kathy, definitely, who's been really supportive.
Yeah.
But I think that's going to come to you. I can't be sure when that'll happen. I think that's part of what I'm excited about the storyline is
yeah.
like, and why I think JB needs to be around for a few more seasons. Because
100%.
I feel like it would be a shame if the audience never got some of those answers and, you know, what happened out in the field and all that. So it's coming at you. And you just got to, you know, hang in there and it'll slowly reveal itself, just like the characters, a little layer.
Little
peeling
by little.
Back, peeling it back.
Yeah.
And can't give away too much too soon.
I like it. Mm. And one more before we go, because I'm just curious to know.
Okay.
What's the best advice Tyler Perry has given you?
Oh, man.
Because I know I say what's the best advice you've given, but now I'm narrowing it down to Tyler Perry.
Mm-hmm.
It could be about anything, life, acting.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I can't remember the exact quote, but... there was definitely a moment that was special to me. First of all, he's pretty like
chill guy.
To me, he doesn't say a ton while
right.
while we're filming. You know, he's great, and you know, he just kind of give me a fist bump, like nice job, you know.
Right.
And I love that. I love that. Like he's not like, oh, great job,
yeah.
or what are you doing? He just kind of, you know, lets me do my thing and steps in when he needs to. But then after a scene, he's just kind of like a fist pump, and so it's like, okay, I buy that. You know,
yeah.
I buy that he means that because he didn't have to make a show of it. And then after we wrap, and he just. Both times he kind of surprised comes up, gives you a hug.
Aww.
And says, I'm proud of you. And I think those are just the best words anybody wants. You're always the people that you care about and you look up to, you want to make them proud. And so
exactly.
that's special. But this was a piece of advice he gave without even meaning to. I asked him, we were out to dinner and
okay.
I said, could you have ever imagined? He was showing us like his island in the Bahamas.
Yeah.
And, like, just in talking about his story, he came from Louisiana and didn't come from much. And I
right.
just, I said, you know, could you have ever imagined that you would be here today? And he said, yeah, I knew. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
And that was cool. Cause I was like, yeah,
you have to
you just
believe.
Gotta know, you know?
Yeah.
And that people, it's probably frustrating for some people to hear that. It's like, ah, that's not true. But no, it is like most everything's possible. So many people have great ideas. It's just, people aren't finishers necessarily, or they don't, you know, commit to something and believe in themselves enough. So I think that was just like kind of, for me, the kick in the booty,
yeah.
kick in the butt to say, no, believe it. Believe in yourself. Believe you can do it. Same for everybody else. And
you can.
And you'll be amazed. And if you don't, it's like the whole, like, if you, you know, shoot for the moon, you'll land in the stars. It's
yeah.
true. Like, if you just work hard and are a nice person and care about people, empathetic, and bring the best of your abilities, you're going to be in a good place.
This
I don't
is
know,
very
wherever
true.
Wherever that is. So.
I like it.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you so much for coming on again.
Thanks.
I had fun.
It's good. Like, I'm meeting
you.
Press people slowly and interviewers. And
yeah.
you're the only face that I've seen multiple times
Yay!
Now. So. Yeah.
I love that.
Well,
you're
my girl.
Thank you. You can tell them where they can find you on social media.
Facebook fan page at the Brad Benedict. Instagram and Twitter at Brad Benedict. And, yeah, I love to... you know, keep up with the fans, so hit me up and I'll hit you back.
There you go. And you,
you.
Can find me on my website, AnnikaMichelle.com, and Instagram and Twitter at AnnikaMichelle1. Thanks for watching, guys.
Thanks, guys. Take it easy. I'll be back.
Yes.
I'll be
Can't
back.
Can't wait.
I'll be back. I love Arnold.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Bye.
Buzz
you later.
Yes.
The views expressed herein are those of the host only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.